Welcome back to the broadcast. Let's get into this here. I'm curious the kind of reception the American Relief Bill is getting in your district. Is it welcome there in Texas?
Yeah, absolutely. People are excited about it. I mean, you know, think about it. People are going to get money to help pay for child care. The child care tax credit is going to, people are going to get an additional $2,000, up to $8,000 for two or more children. I mean, what's in the bill is absolutely incredible. And I think more importantly, for people that have had to stand in long lines at food banks or be in food bank car drive-ups, the additional $1,600 that they're going to get, $1,400 that they're going to receive in their pockets, is just going to be amazing for them. And at a time, particularly for Texans, as we went through that winter storm where everyone lost their power for days, I mean, the timing of it is amazing and just much needed.
Yeah, well, some people are going to have to pay off some pretty extraordinary energy bills because of that storm, but we won't go there right now. Let me ask you about where we are in this first weekend since Texas reopened with a 100% zero mask mandate, right? Do you have concerns about that? Are you hearing concerns from your constituents about their health and safety?
Yeah, people are very concerned about it. But Alex, what I will tell you is that it's really amazing how the business community has decided that that was actually not smart for the governor to do that. Mm-hmm. And so many grocery stores and so many other places around town, particularly here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area where I live, are still enforcing this. And I know that there are probably places around the state that aren't, but I think that for people that are really paying attention to what's going on out there, worried about the new variants, the new strains, you know, unsure or haven't received their vaccine yet, that they want to be cautious and really move slowly. We understand we need to reopen the economy. We need to get our schools reopened, but people want to do it safely. Most Texans are in that category.
Is there any concern about the threat of lawsuits as the city of Austin faced because they refused to go by the statewide mask mandate and said, hold up, we and our citizens here believe that wearing masks is good for our health, so we're not going to go along. They got sued. They won. But do you think that Texas will lob more, I mean, the Capitol will lob more lawsuits to communities like the Dallas-Fort Worth area if they don't go along?
I don't think that you're going to see more lawsuits. I think that that a lot of what Governor Abbott is doing is that he's trying to, you know, take attention away from the fact that he really screwed up the storm response. And that so much of that rests at his desk. And so he's, you know, doing these things to try to take attention away because his approval ratings have been plummeting since the storm. And I think that just people need to keep that in mind and keep that in focus, that a lot of this is politics coming from the governor, and that people in Texas want to be safe. And again, when I was out this weekend, I ran several essential errands. People had their masks on, and stores were still enforcing wearing masks. As a matter of fact, one place that we went, there were people that tried to walk in without a mask, and they said, no, you can't come in. And they got a little bit angry, but they handed them a mask. And guess what? They went in and they did their essential shopping.
Yeah. Let me ask you about something that really caused a lot of eyebrows to go up, and that was Globe Life Field in Arlington, which is going to allow 100% capacity, 100% capacity for the Texas Rangers home opener next month. That is more than 40,000 people. Fans, they're going to be required to wear masks. But what's your reaction to that? Can you even imagine a full ballpark at this point in just a couple of weeks? And let me note that the Houston Astros have said, we're not doing that. We're going to figure out how many fans to let in, but we're not going full throttle 100%.
Yeah, well, you know, Ranger Stadium is in my district. Mm-hmm. And when I saw that, I was shocked. And look, I know that that the virus is not as easily spread in outdoor spaces, but when you're talking about 100% capacity, you're really taking an unnecessary risk. I think that there certainly could have been ways to accommodate people going to opening day. And look, I love opening day. I think there would have been a way to safely do that. But saying 100%, I think is going too far. And, you know, we're going to have to pray that people, you know, that it doesn't become a super spreader event, particularly at a time when we have vaccination rates going up and we have people contracting the virus going down. We need to stay at that trajectory. and having 100% capacity event at that large of a venue is just not good to me.
Yeah. Let's take a look at the southern border with the Biden administration now deploying FEMA to help with that surge of migrant children. Texas Governor Greg Abbott is blaming the president for this situation. Take a listen.
It's the Biden open border policies that are inviting even more illegal immigration and actually have created this humanitarian crisis.
You want to respond to that?
Again, him just trying to basically play this game where he's going to take attention away from the fact that he really jacked up the storm relief response. The Republicans created the problem that is happening at the border. There were programs that were put in place before Donald Trump became president that allowed migrants that were underage minors to be able to apply for asylum in their own countries. And of course, you know, we need to invest more money in helping to stabilize the Central American countries. So people won't have to take that very dangerous journey to our southern border.
Yeah.
And that's what we need to be focused on. Look, Republicans had 2 years, if you think about it, from January the 20th, 2017, until January the 3rd, 2019, the Republicans had a chance to pass a comprehensive immigration reform bill that could have dealt with this, and they did absolutely nothing. We voted on nothing on the House floor that would have addressed this problem, and that is why we're having the situation that we are now.
All right.
It has nothing to do with President Biden.
Texas Congressman Marc Veasey, good to see you. Thank you so much. Talk about